Winter's class has been going.
Sucrose, wait! Honorary Knight, Paimon, please stop her!
Wait, what's going on?
Whoa! You scared Paimon! What's gotten the two of you so worked up?
Sucrose and I agreed to present the wine ingredient to you together. But when she heard that Razor will be showing up, she insisted that she won't spend a moment longer here than she has to.
I'm not good at dealing with strangers. Anyway, as long as the ingredient gets into the right hands, that's all that matters.
Oh, that won't do. We worked on this together, and we should present it together. I can't take credit for what you did.
It's not about the credit.
Wait, so does this mean the Knights of Avonius's ingredient is a product of bioalchemy?
Yes, it's a quadruple sweetness sunsetia.
Oh, Jesus.
Quadruple sweetness? But aren't regular ones sweet enough as it is?
I would imagine.
Also, why a sunsetia?
Okay, let me give you the full story. I love the scent of wine. And after reading up on the art of winemaking, I've grasped some of the key principles. In short, whatever ingredients you use, it's essential to include something sweet. In an attempt to select the most suitable ingredient, I gathered samples of all the sweet plants and fruits I could find in the Mondstadt area. Then, I tried them all in turn and took detailed notes. I also factored in the differences between the same ingredient grown in different locations. For instance, sweet flowers from Springvale are a little sweeter than those at Cape Oath.
That's a lot of work. Good to know, though.
Wow. That sounds like a lot of work.
It was no problem at all. Just my duty as a maid of Favonius. The chance to source the Defender's will on behalf of the Knights of Favonius is a huge honor for me.
Noelle, your eyes are sparkling, but Paimon thinks it could be because of Lisa's brainwashing.
Anyway, I was worried that my evaluation would be too subjective if only I were involved. Thankfully, I ran into Sucrose the other day on her way out of the lab.
Oh no!
What is it, Sucrose?
I just remembered why I left the lab that day. I was supposed to go and fetch some lab equipment we imported recently.
Oh.
Uh-oh. That look on your face seems to say you forgot all about it and have been in the lab this whole time.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Don't worry about it. It's my fault, really. I'll go and see Marjorie about the equipment shortly. Carry on, Noelle.
Oh, okay. Anyway, Sucrose is a true professional when it comes to this kind of research. I showed her my list, and she made some extremely valuable suggestions.
Please, you don't need to go out of your way to compliment me. Noelle filled me in on the background of the whole situation. I was moved to see how seriously she took this task, even though she'd never even met Razor before. However, none of the potential ingredients she had identified were perfect candidates. In my opinion, what we needed was a fruit high in sugar and easily fermentable. After a final look at Noelle's list, I picked the Sunsetia sample from near Cider Lake as a basis, with a view to improving it. Using bioalchemical techniques, we were able to amplify the sweetness, then conduct a few tests to compare the results against the benchmarks.
Watching Sucrose work on an experiment when she's in the zone blew me away. Such focus and determination.
I already said don't compliment me. Anyway, the result of our research is the Epsilon Series Tetrasweet Sunsetia, Variation 63. And it's finally ready. The sweetness has been verified through rigorous testing. And the size and color are both optimal, too. Noelle shortened the name to Quadruple Sweetness Sunsetia. Unfortunately, it can't be produced on a very large scale under the current conditions. But as long as we have enough for Razor. Traveler, there's something else I'd like to share with you. Growing up, I was lucky. I was never the best at dealing with other people, but my parents never placed any expectations on me. They never said to me, "You need to be more sociable," or anything like that. They just said I should do what I enjoy.
That's nice.
So, I'm well aware that I'm one of the lucky ones. I haven't lived Razor's life, and I can't pretend to imagine what it must have been like. So, I don't know how much it will mean coming from me, but I truly hope he can find happiness and spend his life doing what he loves.
Oh, Sucrose.
Sorry, I am late again. Teacher forgot about the time. Kept talking and talking.
That's all right. We were just chatting. Whoa, deja vu. Paimon said the exact same thing 2 days ago. Wait a sec. Where did Sucrose go?
She was out as soon as she saw Razor.
Wow. She disappeared the moment he opened the door.
Yeah.
Hello. I'm Noelle, maid of the Knights of Favonius.
Hi.
Here's our ingredient for you. Oh, but I can't take full credit for it. I had help from an alchemist, but right now... She... Right, yes. It's a shame she couldn't be here to present it to you in person.
Smells like potion, nectar, and animal crystal fly, right?
Nothing gets past your nose, does it?
This sunsetia is sweeter than ones I have smelled before. Klee said alchemy is amazing. It can make things better.
That's right. I hope that this sweet fruit will help you brew the sweetest wine.
Thank you all. When she has time, I want to thank her also.
Leave that to me. I'll figure out a way to persuade her to, to not work so hard all the time, so that I can introduce you to each other.
Okay, I will wait.
Alright, now that we have all the ingredients, we can finally start making the wine. For that, we'll need a barrel, which, if Paimon remembers correctly, is waiting for us at the Angel's Share stand. Bye, Noelle! We're gonna head off now.
Good luck with everything. See you next time.
Unmerry Knight Razor over here! Look who it is!
Wow! It's Diana! Paimon was sure we'd run into you at the Cat's Tail stand sometime, but so far, we haven't seen you all festival!
Ooh, traitors!
What?
Ugh, I'm so mad!
Yeah, we're kind of helping alcohol industry go further.
Klee told me the whole story. So, this bright idea was a brainchild of you two? How could you? Razor is Daddy's friend, and he was a good influence, right up until you got him interested in wine.
Yeah, that wasn't our fault, though. Not completely, anyway.
Razor, you better promise me that you won't turn into one of those old booze hounds that drinks themselves silly, slumps over the bar, and bursts into tears!
I don't understand.
Sounds like there's been some crossed wires here. Klee, what exactly did you say to Diana?
I told her that Razor's looking for his mommy with the Honorary Knight's help, and you both seemed really sad and said you needed some wine so maybe Diana could help. But before I finished, Diana said, "Klee, say no more! I'm getting involved in this if it's the last thing I do!" And then we came here.
Okay. Paimon doesn't even know where to start. Diana, it sounds like Klee left out a few important details in the story. Let us set the record straight. So you're saying, Razor wants to make the same wine that his mother and father once made? So he can learn more about them? You better not be making this up to try to pull the wool over my eyes.
Sorry, Diana. It was all Klee's fault for not explaining it properly. So, are you still mad? Or can you help Razor make the wine? I caught a bunch of fish for us to eat. And you can pet Dodoko too if you want.
I wasn't that angry. We're just trying to help, I understand. I just don't want Razor being led astray, that's all. That's why I may have raised my voice a little bit just now. Well, since none of you plan on drinking it, then I suppose I can help you just this once despite my reservations. But I need you to know that I'm a mixer, not a brewer. So I'm used to working with the finished product. If you really want me to start with a bunch of raw ingredients, that's fine. But I can't make any promises about how it'll turn out.
Yay! Diona is the best!
Bunch of flatterers. Now watch this.
All done! That was quick! Now we just need to find a place to store it. We wait for a windier day. Does that mean we need to put it somewhere exposed to the wind?
Maybe Windrise? Very windy.
Yep. If you say the word windy, that's the first place on every Mondstadter's mind.
I mean, it has literally the word wind in it.
Cool! I want to come too.
I have to keep an eye on my foolish father, so I won't be joining you. Klee, come and play again some other time.
I will, I promise.
Ah, what a curious coincidence meeting you here.
Hundef Bard, what are you doing here?
Well, I awoke to the most magnificent aroma in the air. After following the sweet scent of fresh fruit to its source, this is where I ended up.
Yeah, the fruit are super fresh and super duper sweet. I can smell it as well.
Let's be honest. He's here for the drink.
Yes! I remembered something important. Something that you have to do before sealing the barrel and burying it in the ground.
What? We missed something?
Razor, do you still remember the scent of that half bottle of Thousand Wind wine? I believe there was a hint of bitterness in there?
Yes, there was.
And with very good reason, too. The source? This!
Dandelion seeds?
You're familiar with dandelion wine, right? Well, the people of Mondstadt believe that the wind can bring back the soul, and also preserve memories. Dandelion seeds are like living gemstones, formed from the first wisps of wind in the year. People add them to the mix at the last second, as a way of capturing the wind in the very moment that the barrel is sealed. The memory of that moment is then stored in the wine for all time. So, Thousand Wind Wine is the original dandelion wine.
Wow!
Fun fact, I guess.
That's so cool! So now our story will be made into wine too!
As for why it always has a different scent, well, that's because people have the freedom to include whatever ingredients they want.
What is it, Razor? What you thinking about?
In Mother and Father's wine, I can smell dandelion seeds. But I don't know what else. In my wine, there is a lot of friendship. I still don't understand my mother and father, but I still have you and everyone else. Everyone has done so much for me. Farka, Teacher, Klee, Bennett, Uncle Brown Cat, Cold Lady, Grown Up with Fake Smile.
Grown Up with Fake Smile. I wonder who that is.
Gray Tough Girl, Person That Smells Like Animo Crystal Fly, Uncle Brown Cat's Daughter. Green Bard, Paimon, and Traveler. I remember everyone. Making wine is hard work. Making this wine needed everyone working together. Hard work with friends? Not so hard after all. I'm so happy. Thank you. Friends are also Lupicol. Whether I'm human or I'm wolf, it doesn't matter. From now on, all of us are together. When I grow up, we will come back here, and we will open this wine together.
What a magnificent monologue. Even as a bard, I don't feel like there's anything else to add. All that remains now is to bury the barrel and wait for the fruit to ferment.
We're finally done! Paimon feels like a celebration is in order! If Paimon remembers correctly, tomorrow should be wind coming day, right?
Wow! The animal god is coming home!
That reminds me. I haven't memorized the song for the toasting ceremony yet. I'd better get back. Friends, I shall see you all tomorrow. Get a good night's sleep tonight. Wait for the whisper of the gentle breeze to rouse you tomorrow morning. Then come and enjoy a performance by the greatest bard to ever grace the streets of Mondstadt.
Wow. So many people have shown up to welcome the animal Archon. Why is everyone crowded around the Angel Share stand?
Tradition holds that the finest wine of the weinlesefest only goes on sale after the Animo Archon has tasted it at the toasting ceremony. Everyone's waiting in line for the big moment.
Gotcha.
So welcoming the Animo Archon back is just a means to an end for them, huh? What about you, Lisa? Are you here for Razor?
Yes, I was feeling a little concerned about him, but I just spoke with him, and he tells me that the winemaking went very smoothly. Ah, such a relief. A glass of the festival's finest will go down smoothly now, too.
Wow, you too, huh?
Razor and the others are over there. You should go say hi.
Hey, hey! There you are!
What's going on, Benny?
Whoa! What's with all these bottles? Selling your own homebrew now?
These are for Razor, from us.
Mommy said that everyone's welcoming the animal god today, and we need to give him some wine. If the animal god likes the wine, he'll turn into the wind and bless everyone. We want the animal god to be happy, so he helps Razor. Oh, honorary knight! Look what Albedo let me borrow!
This bottle is from my dad's. Luckily, I managed not to break it on the way here. It's just for show, though. I have to give it back to them afterwards.
Mommy said that the animal god can drink a lot of wine. She said, if he wanted to, he could drink the whole of Cider Lake in one big gulp! So, do you think we'd have enough between these and the wine raiser's parents left behind?
Ah, Green Bard.
Everyone, I am greatly honored to be able to be here today. I have been invited by Acting Grandmaster Jean of the Knights of Favonius to perform a piece for everyone. Thousand Wind Wine. It is some of the finest verse I know. I dedicate it to the wind and to everyone here with us today. Fill up the barrels and store them away, then wait for a windier day. Wax the bottles, seal them tight, for the south wind that soothes, for the north wind that bites. How does this fine wine taste to the tongue, as Mondstadt to the ear, like a sweet dream of freedom? And what are the fruits that went into the brew? An explorer's courage, a love tender and true. A defender's will, strong as yesteryear, joining the thousand winds in a song of good cheer, turning sour into sweet, bitter notes fade away as we wait for a windier day. Pray tell, what treasure does this barrel hold? 'Tis wheat's greatest triumph, the true liquid gold. As it flows from the keg, what sound drifts by? Wind chimes in the boundless immemorial sky. We raise up our glasses and voices in song as we wait for the wind to sing along. Where do we turn once the thousand winds take flight? To the tales of the lyre, to the sweet dream of tonight.
Dear friends, Let us now open the wines.
To the Animal Archon!
I wonder how long it took her to record that.
To the Animal Archon.
There's no wind.
Don't feel sad, Klee.
But why didn't he come? If the animal god didn't come home, is it because he doesn't like the wine we brought for him?
Of course not. You know, Klee, the wind isn't the only form that the Animal Archon can turn into. He can turn into anything. So today, he must have come back looking like something else.
Huh? Really? Maybe he turned into a Jumpy Dumpty.
Sure! Jumpy Dumpty it is! Hope you're listening, Animal Archon!
shit.
Racer, did the Animal Archon bring you a blessing?
Calling him out.
Yes. I talked a lot with you all, and I learned a lot. Now, I am not afraid. I think that is a blessing.
Don't forget to save me a glass of your wine once it's finished fermenting.
Yes. We share together, and we remember together.
Yay! But now I'm getting thirsty.
We've all done a lot of talking. Let's go get something to drink, shall we?
I heard that the Angel Share is selling a new drink called Fruits of the Festival. Everyone's saying it's delicious.
I want some! I want some!
Okay, everyone. Let's go.
Take this, crush it, and place it on the fracture. Listen, Missy. Promise me, you'll live on. This is where you must stay. You are our only hope. Forgive me, Kaya.
Very good. That's my boy. I will always be proud of you.
After all the time we spent on it, the wine still isn't ready. May as well leave it for our son.
Razor. What do you think of that name?
Oh, an adventurer's name. Yes, I like it.
Razor!
That was adorable. Getting little hints of certain people's parents. And Rosaria actually smiling. I'm sure that'd be a first.